Now in this video we will discuss our first preparation of steel. Now how steel is being prepared? So there are basically two steps in the preparation of steel. Okay. The first step is the apparatus that you can see, the diagram that you can see. This is called basic oxygen furnace or basic oxygen converter. This is the main apparatus used in the preparation of steel, and you can see the labeling. We will discuss this. The process of steel preparation that completes in two steps. First step is the purification of pig iron. Now what is pig iron? The iron that has been obtained from the blast furnace that we have discussed in the extraction of iron, that iron is a low quality iron because it has maximum amount of impurities, so that iron is called pig iron. It's a very low grade iron and it has maximum amount of impurities. So the first step is purification of pig iron. So we must know what type of impurities which are commonly present in pig iron. First one is 5% can be changed of carbon, sulfur, silicon, and the next one phosphorus. These are the common impurities present in the pig iron. Carbon, sulfur, silicon, and phosphorus. These are the common impurities. Now why this is called? The furnace is called what? This is called basic oxygen furnace, or you can say basic oxygen converter. Why this name is given to this furnace? Because all the impurities present in the pig iron are first oxidized with the help of oxygen that will be entered through this pipe into the, this is the mix, this is pig iron, molten pig iron. So oxygen will get entered. All the impurities will oxidize, so this is called basic oxygen furnace, or you can say basic oxygen converter. Now how this happens? Carbon will oxidize to carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, gaseous form. Sulfur will oxidize to sulfur dioxide. Now all these impurities are in the gaseous form, so they will be exit from the top of the furnace, these gases. From the top of the furnace, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide and sulfur dioxide, these are gaseous impurities. So given out from the top. Now the impurities left, silicon and phosphorus. They will also oxidize. Silicon will change into silicon dioxide and phosphorus will change into phosphorus pentoxide. Now both these impurities are in the solid form. So if they are in the solid form, it's not possible that these impurities can go out along with gas. This is not possible. Solid impurities are very heavy. So whenever we have solid impurities, we are using limestone. Why? Limestone that will help in the preparation of slag. Slag is commonly the mixture of solid impurities. And for the preparation of slag, we need marble. So marble is also added in this furnace. Now, these solid impurities will be removed in the form of slag. Now, what is left inside the basic oxygen furnace? Molten iron, and that's in the pure form. Now, what to do? This is a diagram. This is a pipe through which oxygen will enter, also called lens. Okay. Now, we have what inside the furnace? Now inside the furnace, we have molten iron without impurities. So, step 2. What is step 2? Now what we have inside the furnace? We have molten iron. And that has, now this is not pig iron because the impurities has been removed. So now if you want to make any type of steel, the required material, what that means is added, is mixed with this iron. For example, if someone need to make a carbon steel, so what it means, mix carbon with this molten iron. If someone is going to make a manganese steel, what it means, mix manganese with this type of molten iron. If someone needs to make a tungsten steel, what it means, mix tungsten with this molten iron. This is the second step. So the first step was the purification of pig iron, and the second step, what quality of steel you need, you have to add that the next component. If you need a carbon steel, definitely you will mix carbon. If you need a manganese steel, you will mix manganese. If you need a tungsten steel, you can add tungsten. Now the next is about different types of steel. We'll make a table to explain those all. Different types of steel. So I will explain different types of steel with the help of a table. So what that type of steel? First, we need a type of steel. What's the name of that steel? In the second column, we will discuss the composition. Composition of steel. In the third, we will discuss properties. And in the fourth one, we will discuss uses where these steel uses. Steel composition, properties, and uses of that specific steel. The common one is this is a common steel. Steel, what it means, 99.5, you can say 99 of iron and plus 0.5% of carbon, a very less amount of carbon. This is called mild steel. This steel is, it can be easily worked. Why? There is very less amount of carbon, so you can shape easily to different. Okay, so this is, it is used in car bodies. Okay. Most steels used in car bodies, in different parts of the car and machinery, you can say, it's being used. The next, this is a type of carbon steel, because carbon has been mixed. The next one is a hard steel. It's also a type of carbon steel. Now we will increase the percentage of carbon. Iron is 99%. And carbon is 1%. So mild steel and hard steel, these both are called carbon steel, because the next component is carbon. Okay, so it's tough, as we have increased the amount of brittle, as we have increased the amount of carbon. So where this is used in cutting tools. Okay, as we have increased the amount of carbon using blades, all blade is also a common cutting tool, as we have increased the amount of carbon. The next one is manganese steel. What that means, if you are mixing manganese with iron, Mn stands for manganese, this is called iron is 87% and manganese is 13%. This is the next type of steel, manganese steel, as we have mentioned, manganese. It's also tough. And the next common property is that it's a springy like a spring. We are talking about what? We are talking about manganese steel. Okay. So what are the common for drilling? Okay. So each steel has its own uses, and the uses depend on composition. Okay. So the next steel is, now we have discussed three types of steel. The next is stainless steel, a very common steel. Stainless steel. So many components at your home consisting of stainless steel. Iron is 74%, then chromium 18%, and the next component is nickel. Now three metals are being mixed, and this is a very common stainless steel. Okay. Tough, but the main property of stainless steel is there is no rusting. There is, why chromium and nickel are being used, so there is no rusting cutlery. Common things at your home, those are mostly consisting of stainless steel because it has no rusting. Okay. It's the common use of surgical equipments. Why? No rusting. Okay. The next one is tungsten steel. What it means? It means tungsten has been mixed with iron. Okay. So iron is 95% and tungsten 5%. Okay. It's a very harder. Even it's a very harder at high temperature. You can say this one of the toughest steel. It's a very harder. So it is of ages of cutting tools, as this one is a very hard steel. So commonly there are five steels in the syllabus that you have. This was all about steel. Now the common question, these are alloys, so we must know what are alloys. So the next is, what are alloys? Alloys are basically mixture of metals, but sometimes non-metals like carbon is also mixed. Carbon is a non-metal. But in most cases, metals are mixed and the mixture of metal is called alloys. But sometimes carbon, which is a non-metal, we have discussed carbon steel. So carbon is also mixed with metal. Why alloys are formed? Metal. So if you are taking any metal, each metal has some good qualities and each atom having some poor qualities, each atom. So alloys, how alloys are made? Using qualities of metals and minimizing poor qualities of poor qualities of metals. This is the main principle of making alloys, using good qualities and minimizing their poor qualities. For example, copper. Copper is a metal. The good quality is there is no rusting. This is the good quality of copper. What's the bad quality? It's a very soft metal, so it can be cut easily. Now we are taking zinc. What's the poor quality? Corrosion. It reacts with oxygen in the air. This is a poor quality. The good quality, it is a strong metal. Now if we are going to make brass. Brass is what? It is a zinc copper alloy. It means if you are mixing zinc and copper, the alloy formed is called brass. What about brass? Brass is better than zinc and even than copper. Why? Brass is stronger. Stronger means the poor quality of copper that has been covered. Now this is stronger. And the second one, brass is no rusting. It shows no rusting. What it means? No corrosion. What it means? It means the poor quality of zinc has also been covered. So we can make different types of alloys. And the main principle of making alloy is that using good qualities of the metal and minimizing poor qualities of the metal. So we have discussed steel and we have discussed different types of alloys and how alloys are being